Hey everybody, it's AEN Cluck coming at you with a quarter case break of Heritage. What is that? Okay. It was highlighting something I didn't want to highlight. We got all the teams that were purchased are over here. I will take the remaining teams just to make this break happen. Heritage is a weird one. Series 2 pretty much filled up. Heritage, it's just people know. It's one hipper box, and it's no guarantee it's an auto. But the variations, it's all weird stuff. So this and archives are usually either we film quick or we sit on them for a while. So no surprise. Super glued the box. Used a good plastic. This will have, actually, Andy, if you want this, you can pick it up. He's local, Foley, Flag Girl Junior Box Topper. To a kid at the April show. If you guys are local, check it out. Syracuse State Fairgrounds again. April 3rd. Last one was a big show. This one probably be a big one as well. Here we go. I'll try to let you know if I see a short print. Usually they're action shots. So give it to a kid? Okay. Yeah. Pujols, Miguel Cabrera, Nelson Cruz. This one we'll have to put aside. Yeah, the box toppers, they're so hard to deal with. Like, for the Red Sox, this is a short print. Christian Vasquez, action shot. Jonathan India. I actually am grading some stuff for him for PC. Tom Seaver and Corbin Burns. Have to do a dice roll for that. If you hear some hitting of the mic, I'm still getting used to it because it's higher than it normally was. So you might hear me pop into the mic a couple times. Jazz Chisholm. Solaire. Austin Riley. Everything will ship, guys. There's nothing next week, I don't think. There's limited football this week. Brett Gardner. Nice picture. There's limited football this week if you guys want to do it. But Real Marto, I think that might be a short print too. But it's expensive. It'd be like for a division break, it'd be like $50 a spot. Aaron Judge, Joe Barlow, Mike Trout, that's going to be random, Gio Urshela for the Yankees, no longer a Yankee. Is now a twin. Alfonso Rivas for the Cubs. Dylan Carlson for the Cardinals. Flexin' me, flexin'. trying to think. Next baseball product is going to be forgot to send, do a non-baseball, but there's not a lot this year. Will be Inception, which we got a bunch coming into that. The only problem is that stuff has like 3 cards per box. So there's going to be people that, you know, don't get hits. Acuna, that might be a action shot too. What's up, Phil? Sounds much better. I figured I toyed around with it and did some, that's an action shot. Did some, stuff last night, did some videos for the future Eloy for the YouTube channel of openings, did some non-sports stuff, so. And I toyed around with it a little bit. Roberto Clemente, nice for the Pirates. Roberto Clemente, nice for the Pirates. Back to back. So yeah. It's a new mic too. I went to a separate mic totally from a camera. So. Because there's some other stuff I'm going to be doing soon. Brian Goodwin. Brandon Nemo. If you guys like anime stuff, stay tuned to the YouTube channel. Also, if you guys aren't subscribed to the YouTube channel, I'm trying to give away boxes over there. I'm trying to get up to 1,000 subscribers and give away some boxes. Shohei Ohtani. Vlad Guerrero. Wander Franco, number one for the Rays. That's going to Justin, I believe, if I remember correctly. With anime, it's Weiss Schwartz. It's a new product. I'll have it up at I'll have it at both Whedon's and Foothills. It's a new card game. Well, not really new. They just keep expanding it, and like they do RWBY. They did a Marvel adaptation. They've done pretty cool stuff. I opened a little bit of it. I'm gonna have a video on YouTube soon. Of this stuff, it's really nice. The animation, the foils are nice, and it's cheap too. $30 for a 6-pack box, or let's say $80 for the bigger box, and you're guaranteed like rares and Louis Robert and stuff like that. Mike Trout, Boyhood Photos. The extreme rares and stuff like that. Oh, nice. Nice. Yeah, it's called Weiss Schwartz. The two we have right now are Poppin' Party and Morfinka. I think that's going to be an action shot, too. But it's not one of the short prints. But yeah, it's really cool stuff. And did we get an autograph? We did. Gavin Sheets for the Chicago White Sox. Going to Christie and Sons, I should say. Yeah, it's kind of it's like Pokemon, but it's I don't know the rules of the game, but I can tell you the art on this stuff is pretty cool. Very, very cool. So we got an autograph. They're hard to get. I'll have them this weekend. I'll have them up there this weekend. Yeah, we got our foil. I'll have both versions, a couple boxes of each. I'm going to just try them out first, and we'll see how they do. Nice. Cabrian Hayes. These are numbered to 673. A nice even number. I'll let you know. I'll message you when I'm probably going to be Sunday at both, to be honest. I'm not quite sure. I know I have plans Saturday afternoon, so most likely it'll be Sunday for both if I don't get up there earlier, because they are empty, both of them, right now. Josh Donaldson, the newest Yankee. Yordan Alvarez, Ronald Acuna. I don't know when the video might pop up Friday. I'm not sure. I might. Oh, no, I brought him back to the house. I was going to say, I might have some cards sitting around here after the break, but I definitely brought him back to the house. Juan Soto for the Nationals. Working Saturday, perfect. So it'll probably be Sunday, to be honest. I know I got plans doing something Saturday. And I usually bowl, so either way, I'm done by 3 o'clock. Gavin Lux. I'm looking for the Ichiro, or not Ichiro, what's his name? Kid from the Angels. He's got a error card that shows both pitcher and hitter. Ben has been, yeah, I'll have singles up there after the April show. I finally got them sorted and priced. Well, I'm bringing them to the show, so I'm just going to keep filling them, and then the weekend after April, I'll have a bunch of stuff. Yankees, and that'll be fun to go through. For sure. Francisco Lindor. Hopefully we don't have to... Oh, we got another backwards card. Fernando Tatis, who broke his arm in November, just found out a week ago. Oh, please be autoed. That'd be nice. DeGrom, no. So all those action shots I pulled were not. So the short prints are backwards. Usually I look them up before, but... So Sean got himself a Jacob DeGrom short print. So I was wrong again, which is not unusual. Yeah, there's, I want to say there's new Pokemon this week or next week. I haven't got it yet. Probably next week. I know that Billion Star stuff sold fast. I got a little bit of that coming back in. I don't know when. That's all Orioles. But yeah, that stuff flew. The booster boxes lasted a day, which is crazy. Last time, they sat there for the whole release, pretty much. And Christy, I'll warn you right now. Remember what I told you last summer about Pokemon coming out every week? Looks like it's going that way again. I just put in orders for, I'd say 12 products that are all coming out throughout the summer. Acuna, Thomas, I think you're local too. And I know you're a big Braves fan. So if you want to meet me at Whedon's, pick that up. It is not a real autograph. So. I think that's what, either I know you're from Whedon's or Foothills, one of the two. I know that much. I just don't remember which one. Because I haven't worked at either one of them. They lost interest in it. It happens. Now they're into baseball cards. which is, in my opinion, it's more interesting because there's new stuff every month, pretty much. And it's not, like, the same design. It's not the same characters. And, you know, Pokemon was hot for a year. Roberto Clemente again. So. It still is hot, but it's a lot of kids that were into it. Just, they were into it because it was the cool thing, I think. In my opinion. Oh, we got our hit, I think. Nufar for the Cardinals. Seager. Ooh, a Miggy. Hopefully it's autographed. It is not. Miguel Cabrera for the Tigers. I think I'm going Sunday, Thomas, to be honest. I'd almost have to guarantee it. I think that what I have to do is at 12 o'clock. And yeah, so I would almost guarantee it's going to be Sunday. And it just depends on how much I got to bring up to both, which one I hit first. Jared Kelenic, nice. Oh, no. Well, there might be some good stuff. I mean, Pokemon cards... if you guys don't use a card ladder, we'll tell you what's hot. Pokemon cards are up like 15%. Wander Franco! So, they are still hot. It's just... I don't think, like, as many casuals are into it. I think they did their thing. And it was done. There is money to be made in that stuff. I just don't know. I don't know much about it, so I don't open a lot of it. I might open like a box now because I'm getting a ton. But before, I wasn't getting as much stuff. Beer, nice. Tom Seaver, Julio Urias. Yeah. But, you know, I might just, me and Mark do a lot of business, so I might just end up with one of his packages now that I know that. Who knows? I should be getting some graded stuff from him. Yeah, it's hard. Like, Pokemon, you have to know what, I know to look for rares and Gavin Lux. And stuff like that, but outside that, I have no clue. Luis Frias, Reggie Jackson, then and now. Mike Trout, Boyhood. TCG Player is an app. Basically, all you do is scan the card, and I'll tell you what it's worth. I've done a couple buys. That's how I did my buys. I bought some Pokemon at the show. On March. And Duran Duran. Yes. You check it with that, and then you verify it on eBay, and make sure there's no reprints or anything like that, and then go from there. But for baseball, if you have an iPhone, there's an app called Center Stage. Right now, that does the same thing. You scan the card, it'll tell you the last few comps. It's a game changer for shows. Make sure you're not overpaying. Great app. Unfortunately, I don't have an iPhone right now, so I'm still using Card Ladder for a lot of that. Which Card Ladder is an excellent thing, you just gotta type everything in. If they ever got the recognition, the card recognition, it'd be huge. And I pay for Card Ladder. That's how, you know, Card Ladder is a paid subscription. I think Center Stage is too. But it's worth every penny being a dealer. So, we might have a short print or a auto. It is a short print, numbered, not numbered, a black short print. Tristan McKenzie for the Guardians. Center stage, Brett. I'm not sure if it's paid. I just saw it in action. A kid was showing me it at the last show. It was pretty amazing. And just like everything, you gotta check your comps, blah, blah, blah. It's not a miracle worker, but it definitely works. Like, it'll give you the last 5 or 6 sales. It's very nice. Card ladder does the same thing. Card ladder goes back however many months you want to do. If you want to go back a year, it'll tell you the comps for the last year. Bo Bichette for the Blue Jays. Victor Robles. Hopefully he pops back this year. I know he got sent down last year. He's a guy that I had high hopes for. But I sold when he did good in the World Series. The new light is working pretty good, too. It's not as dark. I'm catching that pretty good. Nolan Arenado. The steal the Braves had. So that black card probably means we're not getting a chrome card in this. Hopefully we get a hot box. That'd be nice. Didn't even think of that. Manny Margot. Oh, we did get a chrome card. Very nice. Willie Adams. Cal Raleigh for the Mariners. Did somebody pick up the Mariners? Sean Elite. Yeah, Brian, if you do a lot of shows, that app, I could see that helping people with their collections. Even if you're doing like a private buy. That is definitely a game changer. I'm probably going to, for my business phone, I'll probably pick up an iPhone so I have one of each. Because some of the apps work with one and some don't. So, and I've heard that there might be a card ladder app. Dylan Carlson. That's going to be iPhone too. Not positive. Nico Hoerner, Trevor Rogers. Sorry guys, I'm trying to make this as interesting as possible. Heritage, it's a fun product. Freddie Freeman for the Braves. Sorry, Thomas. It is a variation, though. Savali and Akil Badu. But it is kind of, it's not boring, but it's the same cards over and over again. And there's not a whole lot of hits. There's a lot of short print stuff on it. Like, I'm sure some of these action shots are short prints. But then I second guess it when we see the variations turned around. So, we shall see. Dallas Keuchel, I forgot he even went to the White Sox. Wow. Showed how much I lost interest in baseball last year. Even with the Yankees being somewhat decent, they were still awful. To tell Joe, I said, I know what it's like to be a Mets fan now. They were awful. should have been so much better. All right, box number three. Yeah, no. Did Freddie Freeman sign anywhere yet? Last I heard, it was Yankees or Dodgers with an outside shot of Blue Jays. A little sprinkle in Blue Jays. But there has been nothing. Dodgers, who's got them? Sutton. I'll get with you. You're in one of my chat groups. Box, guys. Padres, too. Well, almost have to with Tatis, but I'm sure he's going to want a long-term contract, and that's going to mess them up in the long term. Tyler Gilbert with Tatis and Manny. So, I like the kids the Yankees picked up at shortstop. He had more hits than any Yankee last year. Bryce Harper. Cy Young. So. A and N clock. It's the and symbol. I usually Brugahan. I like him a lot too. I've been doing more videos of openings and stuff like that, and I'm going to be doing videos at card shows and whatnot. I'll be at the National this year. So if people want to meet up at the National, if we got enough people, I'll do I'll do something special. Jose Berrios for the Blue Jays, number 999, short print. Super short print. And I'm thinking I used to do like a quick 10-minute thing every week, like hobby news, keep everybody informed what's going on. I'm toying around with doing that maybe again every, like, usually news breaks on Wednesday, so like every Friday night. But then again, stuff happens over the weekend. We don't know. Steven Strasburg. Me and my rep actually just brought up Steven Strasburg a couple hours ago. We were on the phone, and he was talking about when cards exploded in 2009, and then with the Steven Strasburg, and hobby boxes were going insane because everybody was hunting down the Superfractor, and the Superfractor ended up getting pulled in a retail product. Shohei Ohtani. If this was the variation, it'd have a pitcher and a hitter there. Dave Winfield on the Padres. But yeah, if you guys are going to the show April 3rd, don't. I know some of you stopped and tried to catch up with me, Mike Trout, at the last show, but it was literally insane, and I apologize if we didn't get the chat. I have never been to a show that was busy locally, that was that busy locally. I didn't even have an opportunity to buy a ton. Because it was just, I think I had 10 minutes in between customers, Miguel Sano, which is not a bad thing, but I like, card shows, part of it to me is like talking with everybody. And I was talking, but it was crazy. Bo Bichette. And anybody that bought anything off me that day, I really appreciate it. It was my biggest show locally ever. Like, volume sold, everything. It was crazy. And the show in November before that was my biggest show before that. So the last two shows have been the two biggest shows locally in 20 years. So that, oh, whoever's got the pirate, anybody have the pirates? Dong, you got, I mean, you got two of them already, but that has a ding in the corner, that Clemente. This might be a hit.
Yeah, it's a hit.
Good luck, good luck, good luck. Max Fried, Gleyber Torres, who might not be a Yankee very much longer either. The rumors hold true. He might be on the move. Gary Sanchez, another former Yankee. Yeah, well, I would like to see any Yankees. All right, here's an Acuna. Let's see if it's different from the one I pulled aside. I don't think it is. No. So that is not a variation, as much as I wanted it to be. Geo. And to be honest, guys, I know I was a little cautious about what was going on with Fanatics, but after hearing their one of their CFOs, or I don't know what his position is, Ryan Luber, on a few podcasts, I actually am very happy about some of the things they're doing. And Louis Robert, and depending on how you look at everything, you are either going to be very happy as a consumer or not. A red parallel, welcome to the show. I'll have to see if it shows up. Aaron Judge. Fernando Tatis Jr. breaks his arm 4 months ago and just finds out. Red parallels. Is it numbered, Christy? Sounds like it's something that would be numbered to 25 or less. But I could be wrong. It'd be on the back. Randy Arozarena. It was numbered? Yeah, was it to 5 or 25 or... Usually if it's short printed, you're going to have a hard time finding what it's worth. But I can give you an idea. Vlad Guerrero. 1 out of 75. It's probably worth 15 to 20 on a good day. It's not too bad. Depends on, you know... Depends on the set. Depends on a lot of things. But somewhere between 10 and 20 for Bryce. I'm surprised red is numbered that high. Usually it's, they reserve red for like 10s and 5s. And DJ LeMahieu. He's the only guy that's rumored not to be traded or gone. Fernando Tatis. We haven't got a chrome or parallel out of this box, so maybe these last two packs will be fun. Kevin Biggio. I remember I was big into him, and then he's not as great as we thought he was. I mean, I did well with him, because when he got called up, I sold everything, but I thought he'd be really good. Got another one of those. Wow, we didn't get a variation in this box, I don't think. Or, oh yeah, we got the Jose Berrios. It wasn't a silver. It was a. All right. So, these cards. I'm gonna roll the dice. If there's two of them, or three in the case where there's three players, everybody will get one. If there's two of them, with these ones, everybody will get one. The dice will decide, except for those, where the card goes. So, like this one, there's two of them. If it's got a fly in the warehouse, it's driving me nuts. If it's an odd number, the Cardinals and the Rays would get it. If it's an even number, the Tigers. Actually, you know what? Forget it, because I own the Tigers, so that would be a moot point. But any other three card, if it's odd, it goes to. It'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the other cards, the two-player cards, are evens and odds. That's what I was trying to say. But I was, like, having a tough time. So, 6. So, the two cards would be the guy on the right side. These cards would be the third guy. So, and if I own a spot on any of them, it'll just go to whoever owns the card. Like Astros, Dodgers would get that card. Royals, I think I own. Dodgers would get that card. So it'd be like that all the way through. So it's the easiest way to do it. We're not going to random off base cards like that. So I'll do a quick hit recap. Yeah, I'll get with you on. Just message me to remind me, to be honest with you. I'll be coming from the warehouse, and that's where the card will be. So, we'll do a quick hit recap on a separate video.